What is everybody? Hope you're all doing well. Welcome back to our Esports Talk episode. We've had a lot of news out there about Korean organizations as of late, especially in the League of Legends scene. An update to one of those stories, that being BBQ Olivers, otherwise known as a former LCK team. They are still, though, in the Korean League of Legends scene. They had one of their former players known as Malice, call them out, expose them with many allegations. Just a couple of days ago, he has now been released from the organization in a very weird post. I will say that, guys. It leaves me wondering so many things around this case, but let's keep in mind, his number one goal when he actually brought forward these accusations is he was having trouble terminating his contract and getting out of the organization. That has been done. Congrats to him. He can now pursue other options. But how it all came to be, it's pretty weird. Thanks to a Korean interview or Korean post out there. So there is a bit of a lack of translation. We get the gist of what has now gone on. The organization actually made sure Malice had to come to their formal offices to issue an apology. And thus, if he did that, they would let him go. They'd terminate his contract and they would also not pursue him legally because of his accusations, they threatened to actually take class action lawsuits out against him. Malice went to the offices, supposedly has said sorry to all of the management who he has accused of several things out there, and they have now let him go. But it leaves us all wondering exactly how this went down, because this guy exposed the organization and he has still left out there many accusations. Yes, he has said sorry. He has not taken back, though, everything he has said, which are still on his Twitter and still on this channel. And I will keep talking about it because the things he accused these guys of, the list is very strenuous. And so it's making us all question when it comes to an organization, especially in Korea, versus an individual player out there who, by the way, was already struggling financially. All of a sudden, he was potentially told to say sorry, then we'll let you go and we will not sue you. Which, by the way, you can imagine trying to hold up a class action lawsuit against an organization as an individual would be very financially taxing for a player who, by the way, has not been paid for at least 3 months from that same organization, BBQ Olivers. And so of those allegations, if you guys have not seen my previous video about this, Malice has accused these guys of several things. Now, I get he has a bad past when it comes to offending Korean players out there. I understand that, but still, when you have allegations of, you know, threats of physical violence, you have verbal violence, you have lies, you have manipulation, you have apparently going through your things, possible theft, going through his own personal PC and messages, inappropriate touching, the whole entire LS, their former coach suspension situation is a video in itself. When you have countless allegations against an organization, all of a sudden you say sorry and you're then let go, which, congratulations, I'm glad you're not a part of the organization anymore. And yes, you're not going to be sued, which is great, but it's still, if you are Riot Games or Riot Korea, you must investigate an organization, even if these were some blatant lies, which it seems it could be backed up, at least some of the allegations he did bring against the organization. If you see a situation like this, if you are Riot Korea, you must investigate a situation like this. There are so many strenuous allegations, and some of them do have backing. You must look into this and have a proper response. When a player accuses an organization of anything, I think it warrants some sort of searching. Just like Griffin, if you guys have been following Korean League of Legends, they have been accused of some pretty hefty things. I think in this BBQ case, these allegations could be considered even worse in terms of player treatment. And so Riot Korea, I am asking you, you must respond about this, because Riot Korea is potentially looking into Griffin, and so the same treatment should be said here. Even though it's a lesser team in Korea, it's still just as big of a deal. I am glad Malice is out. I'm very, very glad. Other players potentially being mistreated, though, are still in that organization. Again, we have LS. We have other sources out there who have backed up some of Malice's claims or accusations against the organization. So I think that really does warrant a deeper looking into. Yes, we do have another Korean organization accused of several things out there. There are several wrongdoings, and player mistreatment being one of them. I'll continue to talk about the Asian scene, the Indian scene as well in the future with more videos here, guys, but hopefully something will be done about this. This entire story has me thinking there must be something wrong with the organization. I just want to get down to the truth. If nothing is wrong, then let it be cleared, because in their announcement, that being BBQ, in closing statement here, guys, they say they accepted Malice's apology. They didn't make a single comment really about his accusations besides probably calling them false. And so I would love a deeper looking into by some sort of investigative power out there like that of Riot Korea. Until next time, I hope you guys all enjoy breaking down esports and gaming news stories every single day. If there's a story out there that I miss, feel free to comment it down below and I will cover it as soon as I can. Until next time, take care of yourselves. I'll see you guys back here sometime soon.